Hi, this is Alan Shea. We are here on Our Society Show on June 11th, here celebrating an incredible woman and her incredible family, showing three generations of awesomeness, beauty, and what our community is all about. So we want you to enjoy today's show, celebrating the gifts, the love, and the joy of what family's about.
Yes.
And to see three generations here,
yes,
on what you started 32 years ago.
Yes, you're right.
So this is Alan Shea. Stay with us.
Congratulations. Hi, I see a handsome young man here. Where baby girl at?
I left her.
Oh, okay. Yeah, the heat would have
been
hot.
Red and hot.
Yes. Yeah.
Come on, we'll see Miss Penny when she comes down.
Okay. Say what? Oh, yeah. Okay. Thank you, babe. And thank you guys so much for coming. Yeah. Thank you. Okay. Joseph. Okay. Yes.
Now that you got a lot of time on your hands,
uh-huh,
we need to get back to our eating, because you know that's what we used to do. So
yes, we did.
Let me know.
Okay.
You know, we can at least go to lunch once a week.
That's, yeah, we could do that. We could do
that. I got that in me.
Okay, that sounds good.
Congratulations.
I'll do that. Thank you so much. Thank you guys for these gorgeous roses too.
I wasn't gonna miss it.
Will you take that over to that that table where you sign in at?
Okay.
So they'll say,
they're getting
wilted.
Like,
look at Jeremy.
I saw that.
Yes.
Looking like Tiffany's twin.
Yes. Hey, thank you, baby. Okay. All right.
I'm glad you got an umbrella.
Okay. Thank you. Yes.
I'm
just going to say something.
Thank you, Penny, for everything you've done for Loma Alta. You've been a real jewel. Bless you. Have a great next step in your life.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Appreciate
you. Okay, thank you. Okay.
You were able to be able to enjoy your retirement, so I do appreciate you and stuff like that.
I do want to say one other thing now that I'm not crying. I appreciate the life that you gave to me, to everyone up here. We wouldn't be where we are today if it weren't for you. You created a safe haven for us to have fun, to be youth, to just be free, you know? And we had a ball. Many of my most precious days and funniest memories are here at this park. So I thank you for that, and I wouldn't trade it for the world. And if I could go back, I would. Because I miss being a kid. I miss this, and I'm going to miss this. So thank you.
Thank you. Okay, and that being said, 32 years, and everybody knows that I love giving back, and I love working with people. I've done that all my life. I had 17 years at Girls Club of America, 8 years at Job Corps, and then 32 years here. And I worked 7 years at the school district. So I've just been around kids all this time, and I just love them. And I have a lot of my family here. We come from a large family of 10 of us, and I see my nieces and nephews and my great nieces and nephews and cousins and kids that I've raised, and I just love it. And that's the way we worked here in the park. All of my staff know we work together as family. We looked out for each other, and we looked out for the little kids, the tiny tots, the seniors, and everybody. So I just thank everybody for coming back out and showing me their support, and I'm giving my support back to the community. I love you all, and thank you for 32 years of your support.
Penny, I just want to congratulate you, let you know that I love you.
Thank
and
you.
We do go way, way back. What elementary school did you go to?
Wow, Washington and Madison.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
What junior high? You went to Washington?
Washington.
Okay.
Yes.
So I know you back then.
Yes.
Seventh grade.
Yes.
And the same John Muir High School.
That's
you
right.
know, you went to PCC for a while?
PCC.
Okay,
yes.
All right.
Yes. And then we went on the John Muir cruise together.
Right.
Yes.
And when
yes.
we turned 50,
yes.
we all went on the cruise together.
That's right. That's
and now
right.
we're turning 70.
70, that's
And we're
right.
going to have a party.
Yes.
50-year reunion.
Yes.
Well, 52-year reunion. 52-year reunion.
Yes.
Okay. Let you know I love you.
I love you, too.
And
thank
I'll see you,
you so
soon.
Much. Okay.
All right,
here at Miss Penny's retirement party. Miss Penny is a great lady. She took me in like one of her sons and took care of my kids. We was at this park since, I want to say, 2007, doing Passing the Panthers football. And I became the Loma Alta baseball president. Penny made sure that we had everything that we needed. Made sure the kids had everything what they needed. And we never had to worry about anything. I just like the fact that she always gives more than what she has, you know what I'm saying? So she would give you anything and she would make it up somewhere else, you know what I'm saying? So that's one great thing that I know about her, because she have done it for me and my kids. So we are family, you know what I mean? So it was never anything that we wanted up here. So I'm glad that we made a decision to leave from where we was to come up here and be with Miss Penny up here at Loma Alta Park. It was a great change for us that we came up here, and I would do it again with no question. A great thing that I learned, I'm saying, like, was giving back to the community. So now I give it back to I have a program called the Pasadena Giants. Me and my son, who came out of the program with Penny. We started the Pasadena Giants. It's a youth program that's playing at Robson Park down in Pasadena. I'm having my own training program, which I started here. We started here with 50 kids. Now I had over 400 kids yearly. I've helped over 150 kids get to college, and now we got kids going to get drafted in the NFL. We have kids that's becoming doctors. We have kids that's becoming lawyers, you know what I'm saying? So the fact that my program started here and now has grown to be a national program, we see it all over the social media, all over in the newspaper, on the news. So I kind of owe it all to Miss Penny. Thank you, Miss Penny.
Thank you, baby. Love you.
How you doing? My name's Alonzo Miller. I've known Penny for over 20 years.
Yes.
When she was at the other park in Pasadena. She's one of the best persons I know.
Thank you.
And I hung around with Pootie and all the rest of the family, all of them. I used to be at work the group homes and everything like that. And I just came from Chino to see her on her retirement. I couldn't miss it for the world. She is a really good person, and I represent the Miller family, Anthony and Jamie Miller.
Yes.
And we are happy to see her retire, and I hope to see her more.
Yes, thank you so much. Right. Love you.
Love you too.
I just wanted to thank Penny Daniels for being in my grandson's life, being in my life, and all the years that she spent up here trying to help these kids up in Altadena, California. Because if it wasn't for her, a lot of them would be going in a different direction. But they're all doing good, and they're all doing great. And she's still in their life, and that's what I love about her. She ain't giving up on now one of them. So that's, I love you for that, and I wanted to tell you, for the rest of your days up in here, you're going to be remembered as one of the sweetest, hardest working person that we all know at Altadena, California, at Loma Alta Park. And I mean that from the bottom of my heart. I'm John Long. I'm from Altadena, Pasadena, right here. And I want to tell her congratulations on her retirement and continue doing what she's doing. But it's time for her to relax now.
Okay.
Congratulations again,
thank
Penny.
So
congratulations.
Much. All right, thank you. Here comes our soul sisters.
Yeah, I like the type to eat the fuck till I levitate. I'm the type to make a beat it up and meditate. I don't really got type, don't discriminate. I just sneak up. Hey.
And I see on my lips, take a little sip. Hey. I see your door, hey. And I make a shit grip. Hey.
Yeah.
A rich eight figure, that's my type. I can see why all these basic
like what you see, huh? Don't just let me out here to sound like what?
Please, I want a man with a beat. Yeah. From the bank, I'm dumb on a D. And I see on my lips, take a little sip, privacy on the door. I'ma make a short grip. A rich eight figure, that's my type.
Never been a quick, boy, saw a ticket. I go viral when I talk, period. So I bought it. Watch look small, but a cost. I ain't never been bougie. Pull up in the hood, it's a movie. Pop side up in my
and I'm seeing on my lips. Take a little sip, privacy on the door. I'm gonna make a show quick. Rich, hey, figure, that's my type.
That's my type, that's my type.
Hey, that's my type.
That's my type.
Rich, hey, figure, that's my type.
You guys to give them a big round of applause. If you guys would like to join us, we are going to be here now starting June 16th. We will be doing Parks After Dark, and the class will be free on Thursdays from 6 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. And we will be in the mirror room. Well, it's been all to the good. Thank you so very much. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
Easy. This is how we do it.
Hello, my name is Tamarsha, and I'm an instructor at Loma Alta Park Urban Ballroom Conservatory. Penny has helped our program tremendously, and I just want to thank you so much. Love you!
the lady in front, the older lady in the gray.
Oh, right here, yeah.
Grandmother of line dancing out of Los Angeles. Yes. Well, you should probably get her over today because she just came up here today as a friend for me. A business.
Okay, you know what? I shoot a lot of films with my real interview. I'm not really great at interviewing. That's why I'm out of shape.
Okay.
I'll come up here when you guys want to come here on what, Thursday?
From 6 to 6 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. Okay.
Hi. Okay. We'll do a thing about the dance.
Okay.
Just hoping we're doing the dance about 3 minutes.
Right.
But I'm here, so I might as well do it.
I appreciate that.
No, I appreciate it.
Hi, folks, you know me, this is Uncle Bubba, and this is an amazing lady right here. She has been able to teach young knuckleheads like myself to come up and be a productive person. And she's taught this because the three things that I know she's taught, because she's got them, and that's respect. Mm-hmm. She's got respect for God and herself, first of all. She teaches that. She's got discipline. The only way you could be to have the longevity that she has is you have to have discipline. Mm-hmm. And she's definitely got work ethic. She hung in there for 32 years. Miss Penny Daniels has been such a great community help. And a lot of us wondered why and how she could do the things that she's done, because it's phenomenal, some of the things that she has done. And now I've just found out, because she has backbone.
Yes.
She has strength and she has energy right here in this complete circle. This is one family that I wish all families could take a model and be like, because this family was totally functional. Mm-hmm. They each have found their own lane and they learned how to stay in it. Mm-hmm. Penny took the lead. Well, we didn't know all she had energy, all this energy behind us. Right. But I'm just going to say I'm so proud of him, and I know the rest of you in Pasadena, we all know of her work. She's done so much great work at the three major parks in Altadena. We just want to say thank you, Penny.
Thank you.
I'm going to let Cornell over here has some subjects, some things that he hasn't gotten off of him, and we're going to let him get an opportunity to say those things.
Hello there, people of Pasadena and other places. Good to be with you this evening up here with my sister for her retirement. Like she said, we come from a very close-knit family. Our family is originally out of Oklahoma, our parents, and they were very family-orientated. And I brought this book here because of how blackness and culture and family and the names uncle and all that stuff come from Africa, you know. And so My brothers and sisters here, Cornelius and Jennifer, there, we all come from a very close-knit family and with the mother and father aspect. And this, my sister beams with that. And we know how society is, and there's a lot of families, young people, that don't have, you know, mothers and fathers and stuff like that. And so she played a very important role with a lot of the children in Altadena, Pasadena, especially with the anger with the gangs and stuff. She was very instrumental in fulfilling a lot of void that is in our community due to the circumstances of this country that seems to be worsening. And so I brought this book about Carter G. Woodson because he brought you Black History Month. Let me show that better. So remarkably. So I'm just tremendously proud of her. And I could go on and on and on. So I'm going to turn it over to my sister here because she's closest to me, Big Sis. And I'm going to let her go for it. You're okay about that? Okay. Here's my bigger sister, Jennifer.
You have a lot of patience. She had a lot of patience with the parents. When they come in, they would be late sometimes picking up their children. And she would always be so patient and helpful. And even she brought that to her with the county of L.A. And it really made a difference when she would work with the parents. And I volunteered up there with her many times. And I used to say, give me the office work because I don't think I would have that much patience with the children. And she had so much patience, even with the young adults, the 17 and the 18-year-olds that came in sometime with an attitude. And she'd say, leave him alone. I'll talk to him. And pretty soon they would calm down. And I admire how she could have so much patience when they would be so rude sometimes. And she'd bring them and they'd calm down. I said, Penny, you did a good job. Thank God for people like you. Because I don't know if I would have that kind of patience. And that's what it takes to work in that type of community position. So I admire her for that, and I respect her for that. One of the other qualities that Penny had when she started working for the county, she was over three parks, Charles White, Farnsworth, and Loma Alta. And at Farnsworth had a beautiful auditorium at stage, and nothing was going on there. And she had stage plays from LA coming, and we had so much fun going to. I met Wanda Page from Sanford and Son, and I met quite a few other performers there. And it used to be really something to look forward on Saturday evenings. And those are the things that she brought because she has a good way of communicating with people, making them feel comfortable in expressing their ideas.
I'm Cornelius Daniels, and I'm Penny's brother. We're all like two years apart. I'm very honored to have the chance to express my feelings about my sister on this special day of her retirement, which I've been trying to get her to do for a long time, finally sunk in. But like my other siblings were saying, we come from a very large family. And it was very spiritually based. And Penny is an important link in that family. And she always has been. The things that she emulates through those 32 years that you shared with the county, she already had those capabilities and those attributes while we were growing up. She was always the socialite. She always liked giving directions. And we all learned from that. We were all taught to support each other. So all of us participated in her job. At some point, she recruited us to do volunteer work or whatever was needed. And we had a very strong father head. And he always said, okay, Penny needs you. You need to go up there. And so we would go. And I'm just very proud of her because she had a vision, you know, when she went to work for the county. She had been in other positions. We both worked at Job Corps at one time. We both worked at the Girls Clubs of Pasadena at one time. So she's always been a people person, and she's always had the patience of Job. And you know, anytime you're working with the public, it's a challenge. And Penny is very patient, almost to a fault. You know, even with her staff people, she would go beyond to accommodate them. Whereas, like my other sister was saying, sometimes it's not so understanding, you know, and people rear up and gouge you in the back and you've been protecting them all this time. Penny had that image and that protection persona to guide people and to lead people. And she's very giving, again, like I said, almost to a fault. But I've enjoyed watching her in her career because she's not a quitter. She doesn't give up. And we grew up five girls, five boys. And what people don't know, she's really a fighter. She can take care of herself too. And so this she's displayed at times at the park where she's had to be strong and stand her grounds. And I just appreciate her for seeing the need in the community, to see where there was a need to go up and step out of the box and not be afraid to meet the challenges of that community. And like my brother said before, there was a challenge when she came to the community 32 years ago. The park was in a terrible shape, you know. They were gangs and gang violence and things. People couldn't go and enjoy the park like they wanted to. And Penny tried to convey that to her supervisors, but they didn't have what it took to go into that community. It had to be from a perspective of a representation of the community. And growing up in Pasadena and Altadena, Penny knows everybody and everybody knows Penny. So it was important to have somebody that could go in there and do a job that not necessarily everybody could do. So she went in with the intentions, you know, I'm going to make a change in people's life and I'm going to do it one person by a time, one dent at a time, or with a group. So I'm very proud of her because, like I said, she's not a quitter. And that was quite a challenge. The sheriff didn't even want to go up into that park. So with her ability to deal with people and to understand people, made it an easier job for her and made it more comfortable for everybody to enjoy the park. Penny has always been a strong person. She has a great personality, so she's a people person. And people enjoy being around her, and people will listen to her. And that was one of the things that I felt was important, because if you look at the people that celebrated her, they were mostly a lot of young men. And as everybody knows, that the black man is an endangered species. And Penny went up there and took these people that everybody had pushed to the curb or were scared to come out of their houses at night or come up to the park. And she dealt with them. But she dealt with them from a human perspective, you know, that mother instinct, that sister instinct, that leadership instinct. And so she said, you know, these people are important too. When other people were just, you know, quick to call the police or quick to get them out of the park, she really went in there and found out what makes them tick. And because of that, they respected her. And she gained their confidence. She gained their protection, because there were times when they protected her as well. So I'm just proud that the foundation that our parents laid for us, that she was able to come and transmit that and transfer that to our community by giving them the love that they needed. And that's basically what everybody needs to be, is know that they're loved. And because we were loved in our family, she was able to give that to the people in her park.
Hi, this is Alan Shea, and we were so excited about today. We want to just thank you for allowing us in the community to enjoy your grandmother, your mother, and the Queen of Loma Alta. Thank you so much.